So just recently we have had a change in the capital gains taxation, and this has also impacted the real estate. And to be very honest, the impact on the real estate is very profound. As such, real estate has not been a great wealth creator in the recent past, and as the black money component of in the involved in real estate has been reducing and it is coming more under regulation, the growth in appreciation value, the growth in the value of real estate is no longer as profound as it used to be once upon a time. We often live in the memory of the past and those great and good memories where we saw real estate prices like ballooning keeps us glued to this segment, and we continue to have a deep love for this segment. However, one needs to keep in mind the impact of taxation and impact of growth, and just figure out for yourself that this one decision of removing indexation, how badly it has impacted. So normally what happens is if your growth rate of the real estate is less than inflation rate, which has been hovering around 6 to 7%, if it is less than that, then in the past one never had to pay tax also, even after owning a property for over 10 years. Even I have had this experience that I had purchased a flat for roughly 1.4 crores, and after owning it for 13 years, sold it for 2.75 crores. And to my surprise, and of course it was a pleasant surprise, I did not have to pay a capital gains tax. But had it been the current regime of 12.5% tax, I would have to pay at least a tax of 15 to 18 lakh of rupees, which means that I can consider my sale price not as 2.75, but close to 2.9 or 2.95. And this calculator that you will see right now over here exactly demonstrates what I'm saying. So let's take a case over here of inflation 7%, growth 15%, period in years 10%, cost as 1.5 crores, taxation as 20%, tax rate without indexation is 12.5%. Actual taxation with indexation works out to be 62,35,000. This is after owning for 10 years. And if it is without indexation, like how it is now, then in this case there's a benefit. It is 57,10,421. But now this, I have shown growth at 15%, and where is real estate growing at 15%? A more realistic scenario would be a 10% growth. And if you see a 10% growth, your taxes without indexation is 29, and taxes with indexation, that is the earlier case, would have been 18,79,000. But even 10% is a very high growth. I would rather do it at around 8%, and if you look at it at 8% growth, actual tax with indexation was only 5,75,000, and without indexation today would cost you 21 lakh, even if the rate of interest has dropped from 20 to 12.5%. This is something that you need to bear in mind, and this is why we have designed this calculator.